Hello, it's Blue Satire, and just another day in the console wars that should not exist, but they still exist because people just want a reason to brag. Got the announcement for Final Fantasy VII Remake coming to PlayStation next winter, but somebody wasn't happy, and we all know who somebody is. Because we also got an announcement for a very great prequel to Final Fantasy VII. Final Fantasy VII Crisis Core is coming to all systems. All systems, y'all. A game that was on the PSP, which a lot of people didn't get the experience. A lot of people don't know the story of Zack Fair. A lot of people don't know the origin story of Sephiroth and how all of Cloud's memories came to be. But again, somebody was not happy. And who was that somebody? You guessed it. Xbox fans. And I mean, is their excuse legitimate? Who knows? But to me, no. And let me tell you why they were mad. They are still waiting 2 years for the original Final Fantasy VII Remake to come. And I don't know if they understand that the full team is working on part two right now. And that does take some time away to go ahead and put that on the Xbox. And a lot of people are mad because why would I play Crisis Core if I can't play Final Fantasy Remake? And from what I've seen, correct me if I'm wrong, this is just a Crisis Core remake. I don't believe anything is really just changing except for the graphics. Okay? Excuse me, the gameplay looked exactly the same to me when I played it. It just looks better. It got different voice actors. So there's a possibility that something may change, but it is a prequel to the original Final Fantasy VII that is available on all systems. So why do we have people complaining about, I'm not gonna play this if you're not gonna bring Final Fantasy VII Remake to Xbox? And that goes to a part of the problem that's been plaguing Xbox for years. Something that Phil Spencer is trying to work on with the recent announcements of Persona 5, Persona 3 Portable, and Persona 4 Golden coming to Xbox on Game Pass. Also an announcement that came to that was coming to Steam and PlayStation as well. But nevertheless, Phil Spencer is trying to get a presence of JRPGs on the Xbox and to make his presence known in Japan, because you know, Xbox people will not let you forget that they had 1 month where they sold better than PS5 in Japan after several years. But all I see are countless number of comments of, why bring it to Xbox if you're going to keep the remake off the platform? Make it make sense. I'm not buying this. You're not putting the remake on Xbox, so we're not going to support this. Square Enix is horrible. We don't want this. We're not watching. We're not playing this prequel. You're giving us the scraps. How y'all expect some games to come to your system? Because you didn't get a remake that's on PlayStation, you're mad. You're mad. Exclusivity sucks when it's not you, right? This video game war should have been over years ago, but y'all still drag it with the entitlement that everything should be on your Xbox, on your Game Pass, on your PlayStation. Meanwhile, Nintendo Switch over here just being Nintendo, because exclusives matter. The reason Nintendo Switch is selling 125 million copies. Nevertheless, you can say all you want about how the hardware is not strong enough, not 4K, 120 frames per second. Who cares? It's fine. So, people are really crying about seeing a prequel but not getting the remake. And then they're saying they're boycotting. A lot of people are talking about boycotting. I mean, what is that going to do? And the thing is, there's a history of JRPGs not selling well. There are some dedicated fans on Xbox who love JRPGs, who want more. But the typical fan base, if they have to pay for it, they don't want it. And there's been comments beforehand when Final Fantasy VII Remake was first announced. There were several people that said, oh, it looks cool. I didn't buy it on PlayStation. I'm not going to buy it on Xbox. And if it comes to Game Pass, I'll try it out. And that's what I don't like right now. There's a lot of, I'll just try it out because I don't want to pay for it. And that's cool. That's a perk of Game Pass. But I have a question for y'all. Does that hurt gaming in any sort of way? And this is just a question I'm asking you. Answer that in the comments. Does is this getting toxic? Is the waiting for Game Pass and waiting for games to come on Game Pass making the gaming atmosphere more toxic, because we have people that's laughing at folks for buying games, and we have people that's laughing at people for just waiting and saving a little bit of money by paying for a subscription and just waiting? No matter what, play games how you want to play them, but just remember, keep that same energy. We had a lot of people celebrating the fact that, hey, we just bought Activision, it's gonna be exclusive, what if they make Call of Duty exclusive? And then they were mad that it was gonna be multi-platform. And then we got a lot of people saying, yes, yeah, Starfield, that's gonna be a great exclusive, because it's a great exclusive to the Xbox ecosystem. But now, when it's looking like you're not getting Final Fantasy VII Remake, now you're mad and you're boycotting the game that they are giving you. How is that gonna help anyone? And you tell us to buy a system to enjoy those games, get Game Pass. Everybody should have Game Pass. If you wanna play a game, go get the system on its own. It's also coming to Steam. Exclusivity does still matter. And yes, times are hard, inflation is going, money is going up. If you're able to, enjoy the system, or just enjoy what you have. You won't see a Nintendo game on Xbox. You won't see a Nintendo game on PlayStation. That's why people buy the Switch, because those are the games they enjoy. Sony has been synonymous with Final Fantasy for years. The first Final Fantasy to come on the PlayStation system was Final Fantasy VII. We're celebrating 25 years of Final Fantasy VII. Is it far-fetched to think that they wanted to focus on the PlayStation for a minute because that's what gave them that glory? And keep in mind, the first six Final Fantasy was on a Nintendo system. But we gotta stop spreading this horrible rhetoric and just making this gaming space worse. And I'm gonna talk about this more often, because I see stuff every week. But I finally took the time to just stop and just talk about it and record. Let me know what y'all think in the comments. Please like and subscribe to the video. If you want more conversations on gamers, you got any more questions, want any discussions with me, let me know. And now, first and foremost, this is just my opinion. This is just how I feel. I am a person that has all systems or access to these games. I have Game Pass on PC. I don't need an Xbox, but I can experience the games that I want to experience. I have a PS5. I got lucky. I have a Switch. So maybe that's why I feel the way I do. And there are some people that still just, you know, I'm a one console person. I'm an Xbox fan. I hate Sony. I hate Nintendo. I hate Xbox. I'm just going to play this one system. If you choose the game that way, can you really choose to be mad when the game don't come to your system? Think about that for a second. I'm Blue Satire, and I'm out.